Hello ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. What comes to your mind when you think of South India, especially Tamil Nadu?
I know, right? It's sambar.
While this particular recipe goes amazingly well with idli, dosa, pongal and vada, it's basically meant only for these dishes. However, for plain rice, we use slightly different ingredients for the sambar. So try out this recipe for sure and let me know your comments in the comments box below. Also do support me by a simple gesture, that's clicking the subscribe button and also press the bell icon for future notifications. So let's get started with our sambar. These are the basic ingredients we'll be using. For the radish, carrot and drumstick, you can replace them with the vegetable of your choice also. For the sambar onions also, you can replace them with big onions if you don't get sambar onions. But the authentic taste will come only with sambar onions. Let's start pressure cooking the tur dal with 2 glasses of water, 1 spoon of turmeric powder and half a spoon of asafoetida and some sambar onions also. Save some sambar onions for tempering also and close the lid and keep it for cooking. After the first whistle, lower the flame and cook for 2 more whistles in low flame. Our dal is cooked now. Add 1.5 cups of water to this and we'll be adding the vegetables for cooking along with this now. Cut the brinjal in this manner and put them in the dal. Now in goes our other vegetables also. As I said earlier, the radish, carrot and drumstick are vegetables of our choice. You can use any vegetables as you like. So we are adding in sambar powder now. If you don't get sambar powder, you can also use red chili powder instead of the sambar powder. Add in the salt, coriander leaves. And now we'll be pouring in the tamarind water also with this. Make sure the tamarind is nicely soaked so that you get the tamarind water easily. The whistle count remains the same for vegetables also. After the first whistle, you have to lower the flame and then again cook it for 2 whistles in low flame. Now the vegetables are cooked along with the dal, so we'll start with tempering now. Pour some oil, preferably sunflower oil. Put in the mustard seeds and split over the dal and wait until it starts to splutter. After this, we'll be putting the sambar onions and curry leaves. That's it, we are done with the tempering part also. Now pour this in the sambar and boil the sambar with this tempering for around 1 minute, and then your tasty and yummy sambar will be ready. Here you go, our yummy sambar is ready to be served now. I hope you liked the video. Do try out this recipe without fail and let me know your comments for sure. Here's our tasty sambar with crispy dosa. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye bye.